I always encourage my graduate students to take courses from different disciplines and bring different ideas and tools to be able to provide a unified solution to answer the questions around safety of autonomous systems. I'm Majid Zamani. I'm an associate professor in the Department of Computer Science. I'm a member of the Autonomous System Interdisciplinary Research Team at CU Boulder, and in particular what we do, we embrace ideas from computer science, system theory, and applied math to ensure that autonomous systems operate correctly. Recently, I got an award from National Science Foundation to study correctness and safety of autonomous systems. In particular, this award allows me to be able to collect data from actual systems and try to analyze the data. Being able to bypass the model and directly use data going to the safety analyses, or being able to design software that can ensure the safety of autonomous system, I think that can be a nice breakthrough. Since I moved to CU Boulder, I actually became more active, and one of the hobbies I picked since I've been in Boulder is mountain biking. Since I started going mountain biking, then I started asking this question: is there any self-driving drone out in the market that can actually follow me and avoid colliding with the trees? And we actually end up finding some drones which has that capability. The drone, surprisingly, is able to actually follow me, avoid colliding with the trees. And what we are now currently doing, we are trying to collect the measurements of the drone while I'm in the trailhead. And we are able to actually download those data from the drone. And now we are trying to model a mathematical model for the drone and being able to use that, maybe bring our techniques and being able to design our own software and try to compare our result with what comes from the drone company. This is very important because these systems are life critical. Having a small software error can actually have catastrophic events. It's a matter of life and death, right? So that's the reason it's very important to be able to rigorously and at the same time systematically analyze this system and being able to actually provide a way of making the system correct. What I would like to see in future, the outcome of my research, being able to apply my techniques to real life applications, including autonomous drones, self-driving cars, or any sort of robotic applications.